on their game to start.
All right. Does everybody have their seeds in? It looks like they do.
It sure looks like it, considering they're all matching up.
All right, so hoping for some good matches here. I think we'll be ready to start. Are you guys all...
Hydrant, did you know that this game is from 1882?
That's not the right year.
That's
1882.
Crazy.
All right, you good? I assume the rest will signal to us. Okay, I think we're going to get started here. In 3, 2, 1, Tetris! Classic rhubarb cheer.
Classic rhubarb cheer.
A little bit of a parody of the Buko. So I think starting off here, the top match is probably going to be the more interesting one to watch since they're starting off on 19, and their game's going to be a lot shorter. But we'll obviously have to keep tabs on the 18 game. Fractal has already hung a bar on the left side, so maybe starting off a little shaky here, but he does seem to resolve it just fine.
Might just need a little bit more lotion.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he's... Oh, he's got it. He's got the lotion on the table in front of him.
He needs
to reload.
And the lid is off, so he can reach right
off.
In there.
Locked and loaded.
You know it's serious when the lid's off.
Can we get a lotion?
I don't have glasses, so I can't particularly read the label. But
when I read the label, I think it said Trader Joe's on it. But like, there was another label on top that said Cetaphil, so getting conflicting answers from the bottle. Oh right. No, Rhubarb has topped out extremely early up here at 25 lines. Wallbant is going to take that first game up top.
And Wallbant coming all the way from London, Ontario.
Yeah, I wonder who else came from there.
Yeah, I heard he arrived at about 4 or 5 a.m. last night, so he hasn't gotten much sleep even.
Yeah.
I wonder how he's doing.
Well, so far doing well. Having gotten a bit of a gift there from Rhubarb.
But we are in best of five now, right?
Yeah, so this is best of five, so they'll be picking their next mode. Down there we've got Fractal on a left well right now. Interesting. Didn't quite catch how that transpired, but they seem to be doing it.
There's nothing wrong with a left well, of course, especially not as a roller. You do lose some opportunities for some spins, though, unfortunately.
Yeah, that's one of the biggest differences, is that you can't do a lot of spins on the left well. But the other thing is that it's just a bit uncomfortable if you're very used to the right well. You know, if you have 1,000 hours playing right well and like 100 playing left, it's probably a lot more of a difference than that, but, you know.
I think as a roller, it often doesn't make too much of a difference, but you certainly do have to acclimate to the changes in patterns. But you could mostly stack the same.
Yeah. For Rhubarb Wallbant, their second game is going to be with a no rotation cap, and they're playing 18 through 39. So it's actually the same mode that Fractal and Sodium are playing right now. But Fractal and Sodium have been ahead in lines. In terms of score, we've got Sodium at 323, Fractal at 285. So there's about a 2 Tetris difference in favor of Sodium at the moment. And they're both looking clean, so I think they're both in a pretty comfortable position at the moment. Not a whole lot to call out. I guess Fractal's got a tuck right now, but he gets it right away. And going to get that T-piece as well. Everybody else is actually kind of high at the moment. Everybody got a Tetris.
Yeah.
That solves that.
In general, I think Sodium's often been Tetris ready where Fractal hasn't been. So even though he hasn't been digging, he just hasn't been able to use the bars Sodium has.
Yeah, nice little vits there from Fractal. Sodium dropping the bar on column 9. Kind of the inverse of a vits when you put it there really early. Sodium doing some adjustments. One with a J for an S piece. Sodium is the originator of a lot of the adjustment names together with coffee back in the day. If you've ever called it a 5 and below, you can thank Sodium for that name. You can thank Sodium for not remembering the name of the store correctly. Although I think a lot of us have Mandela'd that one into place.
And a fun little coincidence, if you look at the 5 Below logo, it has a 5 Below in it, the adjustment. It's quite cute.
And I'd like to thank Canine Watching Tetris for the $100 donation, pushing the prize pool over $1,000. We're at $1,069, everybody.
Thank you very much, Canine.
Thank you, Canine.
These players deserve it. I mean, they're doing great. They've come a long way. And this is
Watch Wallbant up here. Wallbant is in serious trouble. Does actually manage to get a piece of left there that's going to sort of lower the pressure from Rhubarb in very much the same situation. So this is getting really tight. And Rhubarb's not going to make the single tap.
And Wallbant takes it, having already been in the lead.
Both players digging like crazy up there. Rhubarb just surviving a little bit longer.
Now game point for Wallbant.
Wallbant surviving a little bit longer with a higher score.
He can make it to the finals on this game.
Yes, this is match point for Wallbant. So Rhubarb looking for the reverse sweep here.
And look at that transition from Sodium, 677.
Wow,
and Fractal
not even that
far behind at 640.
Yeah, Seed has clearly been kind with its timings to these players. They've also been playing very clean. Haven't really seen much digging from either of them.
Sodium having to do a little bit of digging, but I'm sure it won't make too much of a difference in the score differential at this point.
Digging in this game is very interesting because it's extremely luck dependent. You like to think that it's a lot of skill, but in a lot of cases, like, the game either gives you the correct piece or it doesn't. The amount of time that you wait for that piece really determines how long you're going to dig for. But Sodium did get out of that dig and is just trying to get set up here. Had a little bit of a spiry board, but look at all those pieces filling in. It's getting a lot better. Gets the Tetris and the L-tuck. Sodium at 743.
Now a little bit behind.
Yeah, Sodium a bit behind. Was ahead by a fair bit at transition, but that digging really cost him as Fractal's been playing quite efficiently. It's not a huge lead.
About two Tetrises, and Fractal is in a bit of a dig, so...
Yeah. It's actually closer to one Tetris, I think.
Oh, that's...
There's a bit of a line count difference there. Sitting with exactly 800,000. That's a cool score. Don't always see that one.
I wonder, what is the most common zero score?
All zeros? Probably... Well, no, it wouldn't be 100,000, because that's, like, not easy to hit from an 8. Yeah, zero. That is the trivial answer. But, I mean, I think, you know, it might have to be 100,000 because, like, as you get further into the game, there's just less games. So, I don't know. Plus, you can hit 100,000 pretty frequently from a 19 start,
right,
which people do.
I feel like I've seen all sixes a fair amount of times in my life.
What, do you push down?
I think, like, 660-something is common.
Fractal's getting a nice dirty Tetris there. He's trying to clean up this center well. He's still in the lead. It's kind of hard to tell. I think it's actually very, very close in terms of pace. If Sodium gets the next two Tetrises, it looks like Sodium's still one Tetris behind, actually. But there is a bit of a line difference. But we're closing in on a max out here at the bottom. Sodium just 1.5 away, and Fractal gets it right there, A20 right now. And Sodium now just one Tetris away. Closing in on 29 here, so 29 will move to standard kill screen speed. And once we hit 39, the rotation buttons will stop working. So we'll see if they get up there, but for now, they're both preparing for the transition. Fractal's gonna hit it first, actually by a pretty wide margin, and there we go. Goes
in
with a
B28. 1.128.
Be standing for 1.1 million, of course. Media Tetris there. Sodium looking to actually get more or less the same score into kill screen here.
He'll be in the lead if he gets this Tetris. Lead into transition, of course.
Yeah, it would be about 10,000 ahead, but he does not get that Tetris. The bar. If he can get another one over, but he's not going to be able to.
And unfortunate miss on those long bars.
will be the first game at the bottom to Fractal. And up at the top, we have, once again, a match point for Wallbant right now. So they'll be determining what line cap they want. Up at the top, by the way, the mode they're playing is a double kill screen with 18 to 29. So instead of going to kill screen speed at 29, it will be going to twice that, which...
God, that is a massive shift.
Yeah, that's a big change in speed.
And, what would that be? Would that be a 200% shift?
Well, it'd be multiplying by 4, I think.
Right.
Because it doubles and it doubles.
Oh, that's... You'll definitely want a center well setup going into that.
Yeah, that'll be cool to see.
Assuming we make it there.
Yeah, and hopefully we will. Rhubarb has been having a little bit of trouble, but hopefully we'll be able to hold that together. All right, so we are closing in on transition at the top. Rhubarb's at 350,000, and basically so is Wallbant, so pretty much neck and neck there. Rhubarb with a dirty left toss setup. That's pretty high, so it's a little bit risky.
Very, very struggle paces this game up top.
Yeah, these are pretty low for your average game of 18. Looking at probably a low 400 transition for both of them. But remember that in the match, what matters is not, you know, your absolute score, but how far you are ahead of your opponent. And in this case, it's going to be very even. So really not much penalty to either of them for the suffer pace so far.
Wallbant probably going to go into 19 with a 2-Tetris lead, just about.
Yeah, well, where did that lead come from? I didn't see that.
I think Wallbant was just ready a few times where Rhubarb wasn't.
Right. Yeah, they are pretty close. 479 to 510 right now. Rhubarb waiting on a long bar and is going to get it. 501 now. And Fractal...
with a bit of a miss drop, but incredibly lucky pieces there.
I keep reading the Fractal text because it's below Wallbant instead of reading Wallbant, so I keep referring to Wallbant as
nice.
Fractal.
Nice. 5 and below with an S from Fractal in the middle of the stack. Always
Rhubarb struggling
fun
a little
to see.
Bit up here. Does get that bar over and the J piece. That's very nice. But he is kind of getting behind. And this seat seems very droughty.
Very close eyepiece from Wallbant there. Very easily could have hung, and remarkable J's.
Yeah, both players struggling here on level 22. There really has been kind of a drought here.
Ooh,
oh, very bad timing of that burn for Wallbant.
But good thing that a second one came.
Yeah. Yeah, not loving Wallbant's board right now. Very dependent on a lot of pieces. But when you're very dependent, that means that if you do get those pieces, you immediately have a great board.
Oh, that was a very interesting adjustment. It worked out surprisingly well. I'm not sure if that was intentional or if it was just incredibly lucky, but that very much saved him.
Yeah. And now with a pretty satisfying resolution for Wallbant.
And still neck and neck with Rhubarb. Depending
on
the line count, you can even view that as a 1-Tetris lead.
There is a 3-line difference. So now that Wallbant's at more or less the same lines, he is a Tetris ahead, but that's very small. So we're probably going to see a tight battle here as we close in on the kill screen. And remember, this is double kill screen that we're going into, so there's really only 30 lines left to score here.
Wallbant really not getting anything to help him. He's back in a Tetris well, but he's missed the last few Tetrises.
Yeah, this seat has not been kind to either of them this whole game. Now 850 for Rhubarb.
Ooh, tough miss drop for Wallbant. That's definitely going to slow him down.
Yeah, and getting a miss drop this late in the game always hurts a lot. as this is when your points are worth the most.
And you need to get ready for the impending kill screen.
Rhubarb sacrificing a Tetris, waiting for the bar, gets one bar. All right, two
and
more lines left to burn.
And Wallbant's out.
Oh, yeah. Wallbant is not going to survive.
And Rhubarb takes it, already being in the lead.
Okay, 2-1 up top. Can shift our attention back down to the bottom. As Sodium and Fractal close in on transition. And Sodium with another flaming hot pace here. 564,000 at 117. Actually, same for Fractal. It looks like we're going to see another double 600K transition.
It's very easy to forget that Sodium is a top player. Because you rarely see him play, and he's quite a goofy character, so it's always nice to see him put up a good fight against someone you know can win a world championship.
Nice save.
Thank you very much. I'm remarkable at saves. I don't think I needed to save it. That was my point to begin with. I love you, Sodium. I'm sorry. Wait, stop!
All right, what do we have here? 739 for Sodium, 734 for Fractal. A few lines behind, so it's very, very close.
Sodium, oh, it's really hard to tell who has the pace lead here.
Yeah, because they're both in, like, they're not horrible boards. Like, they're scorable boards, but yeah, Sodium is now having to burn with it. Looks like Fractal's has resolved a little bit better.
Right.
But if there's no bar, it doesn't really matter. There's the bar.
Same score at same line count. Very close game. But Fractal going into a dig means Sodium's going to have a chance to run away with it a little bit, which will be not too important in this case. They're going to have floor on 29, but Fractal has practiced that a lot more than Sodium has. So.
And
Sodium will want all the runway he can get.
As a reminder, this is an 18 to 29 game, and on the 29 kill screen, we will see a rising floor. So once we hit 29, the bottom of the playfield will start moving up once per level, and that row will be unclearable.
As I recall, the floor in this particular hack is a replacement floor, right? It doesn't push up the stack.
I haven't been paying attention, so I don't know.
Well, we're about to find out,
yeah,
I hope.
Hopefully we'll find out here, as they're both closing in on the kill screen.
Sodium really taking a lead now. Still only about two Tetrises, but since Fractal's in a dig, it is worth a lot more. I have no idea what Sodium just tried to tell me, but I'll assume it was something positive like, Ella, thank you for the great commentary.
All right, so Sodium already with an A81 here on 27. This is more than enough for a 1.2 into kill screen. But he is probably going to have to take a few burns here, so we'll see if that happens. Still, we can probably expect at least a high 1.1.
A very unfortunate set of misdrops there.
Yeah, but it looks like it might resolve. Oh, not quite.
Not without holes. It would have required a lot of waiting, which wouldn't have been worth it at this point.
Yeah, sometimes you get the right pieces.
Sometimes you don't. But you gotta stack for what you get, not what you want.
Stack for the pieces you want. All right, Sodium hits kill screen with a 1.17. And I didn't see what the floor did, but we're going to see it as soon as he hits level 30.
I believe it replaced, since the surface didn't move up. Yeah.
Yes, it is a replacement floor. And Fractal also on level 29 now, as the floor is beginning to rise. Fractal is behind by about two Tetrises. Oh, and a misdrop there. That is going
Sodium
to cause problems.
Missing that Tetris.
Oh, yeah, Sodium missing a Tetris to the right. If he can get one more bar, he might be able to score something, but he doesn't get it.
Fractal
so
still needs
the chase down is
a Tetris and change to
yes
win.
Yes, 1.19 is the score to beat. 1.19 flat. So 1.191 would take it. But there is not enough room to line out here. He's going to probably need a Tetris somewhere before it gets too high.
He would need entirely triples from this point.
This is going to be a really interesting chase down. If he can pull it off, that'll be extremely impressive.
Lining it out.
Higher and higher. Doesn't get the Z to the left. Valiant effort. Sodium's going to take that, and the score is now 1-1.
And now I won't forget that Sodium is a top player.
Yeah, never forget.
Never
Sodium's
forget.
A top player.
Sodium could easily win the World Championships next year. I'm willing to bet my life on it.
Yep.
Yep. Don't quote me on that.
I'm sorry.
All right, so for the...
Shadow Beepomon. Yeah.
Shadow Beepomon. For the fourth game here of the top match, we're about to hit transition, but the kill screen method is invis. So at level 34, we will see the new pieces locked to the stack as invisible blocks, so you won't see them.
And the invisible mode in this hack is quite jank, as I recall.
Yeah, a little bit jank. Because the stack that you had before it switches to invis will be retained as visible.
Which means the surface you see will not be the one you have for the entire time until you've cleared what was there.
Until you've gotten rid of all of it.
Which is remarkably confusing.
Yeah. I wouldn't know, I've never been there. But you still put it. Alright, so at level 19 and 20 here, we have Wallbant in the lead currently, but I think Rhubarb might actually have the pace lead right now.
Yeah. But only slightly, especially because of this.
Looks like we're going to be taking a break on the bottom match for a minute, so we will focus on the top match only. And Rhubarb with kind of a difficult burn set. If you can get an L piece here, that would... That would resolve really nicely,
but of course, as is always the case in Nestor's digs, sometimes you just never get it, and you look like an idiot, but you did the best you could.
Yeah. So Rhubarb now approaching the bottom of the field. There's a good chance he's going to build dirty here. One row up usually isn't too much of a penalty, especially with rolling.
Right. You could easily play a game entirely one off the bottom, and it probably wouldn't make much difference to your pace or your final score.
I think I did that once against, like, Aaron in a
I've definitely done it in several Masters events, even back when tabbing was predominant.
Yeah. We have Rhubarb at 714 and Wallbant at 774, so that's a 2 Tetris lead for Wallbant.
One Tetris at the same line count.
Yeah, one Tetris at the same line count. And we're on level 24 here, so we are about halfway through the post-transition. Both of them kind of digging. I mean, Rhubarb's not really digging. He's not concerned with that row at the bottom, but Wallbant had a bit of traffic there for a moment. Wallbant at 844 now, Rhubarb at 813.
Surprisingly, it looks like the gap is almost closing a little bit.
Yeah, it's a bit hard to tell. I think they're both Tetrising pretty evenly. But at the same line count, it's still a one Tetris difference. Wallbant taking a safety triple there. Rhubarb, ooh, that's a dirty Tetris. He's not gonna hold it open for very long. He's just gonna clear this out immediately. Very nicely timed J-piece for Rhubarb there. We're now at 862, or let's say 895 to 928 at about the same line count. So still that one Tetris difference has been holding.
That long bar, very helpful, but now still has to clean up a fair bit before being able to Tetris.
Yeah, Rhubarb with some cleanup to do. Actually, both of them with cleanup to do at the moment.
And there's not a lot of time to get pace back later.
Yeah, we do have 5 levels of kill screen before our invis hits. So there is room to win on kill screen for both of them. Especially with the score being this close, I think a lot of it is going to be determined by kill screen. But Wallbant is not going to get that bar over. And a top out at 1.01. So A10 is the score to beat, so A11 would win for Rhubarb. He's at 995. This is a pretty short chase down in the grand scheme of things.
Only a triple, and he has it.
So if you can just hold it together for a few more lines here. Closing in one more line, or two more. 8-10, 7-80, and he has it. Nicely done by Rhubarb there. In 3, 2, 1, Tetris. Okay, so obviously top match, that's gonna be fastest max up. But the bottom match for the fourth round, they will also be doing an invis kill screen. Yes, they will be doing, yeah, it's exactly the same as the last one. So invis kill screen at 34 will be the final chosen. Actually, no, that's not the final. This is only the third game for them.
Right, they've been having very long games. So.
Yes, they've been playing it out to the very end, whereas there was a couple early top outs at the top at the beginning.
I've been thoroughly surprised by the amount of kill screens we've seen so far in this matchup.
Yeah, between Sodium and Fractal, it's been quite good.
I would cry too. Doogie sucks. Yeah.
Everybody's pretty much even. I guess Fractal's behind and digging. Yeah, I mean, Fractal's not in a super concerning position. He's gonna clear that away, and is now gonna be back to regular. Sodium now, okay, had a delayed burn for a moment. He's waiting on the bar. He's getting a little bit droughted, but there it is. 128 to 106 for Fractal, so one Tetris lead for Sodium. And up at the top, why is the top so far ahead in score? I guess the bottom's kind of been having trouble.
They are at the same line count, so it's just been a suffer game on the bottom.
Yep. That, and also the top seems to have been mostly perfect so far. Really not many burns up there.
Which is always nice to see.
Yeah, and it makes sense since they're going for earliest max out. Pace does matter a lot to both of them, so they're probably playing for a little bit more than usual.
Hence the sprawling dependencies on Rhubarb's bar.
Yes, Rhubarb has a bit of a bar dependency.
Oh.
He will get the bar, but not before he puts some more weight on the well on the right side. Could be going for dirty here. That would actually be a pretty clean dirty.
A little bit of
copage. It's almost always a bad move to go for those, but
right. But it just feels so nice when you get it.
Yeah, no discipline.
What's the point in being disciplined if it does you no good?
I mean, it does do you good.
We don't have to talk about that.
It's
no?
Just not as fun.
Yeah, I mean, we're playing a video game here. It's all about the fun.
We have Wallbant at 392.
Could we be seeing another Copewell up at the top?
Could we be seeing another cope wall?
And
oh my
we do.
God.
Always so
ridiculous.
Nice. And as nice as they look, you do have to acknowledge that it has hurt his pace substantially.
Yeah.
At the same line count, now two Tetrises behind.
Oh, nice adjustment. T-piece. We have Sodium at 327 and Fractal at 329, so it's neck and neck down at the bottom. And at the top, Wallbant has about a two Tetris lead. Again, really good pace at the top right now, especially for Wallbant. You can definitely see 500 to 100 lines. That's pace for about a 650 transition. So good job up there.
Very unfortunate situation for Fractal on the bottom. Going for another one of those Copewells and gets it.
That's going to help him downstack, and I assume he's not going to go for anything further. Yes.
And they share pace at the same line count. So, very even on the bottom, within a 1,000-point difference.
Yep. You're doing their 34 kill screen, so we have all of post-transition plus a little bit of post-post.
Wallbant now has an almost 4 Tetris lead, I think.
Is it really? Yeah, that looks like it.
Yeah. Just about 3.5.
Yeah, Wallbant playing extremely efficiently. And that's not to say Rhubarb isn't. Rhubarb's also playing a good game. This could... Is this a 600? I think this can 600, or it's like a 590. Something close. Yeah, it looks like 590. And Wallbant has 624, still back at 120 lines. Again, they're playing for earliest max out, so this pace is quite valuable for Wallbant right now.
Almost it's a 700. The fake 700 yeah, this transition. This is the dreaded one. Everyone's seen this once or twice in their life in a tournament match, and you think it should have been 700.
Yeah.
It always
hurts. If you take more of your burns as triples and you do some push down, that ends up being a 700, but instead it's a 695, which is still, like, insane. What? A triple?
Unfortunate for Wallbant, a lack of vision there.
Yeah, a little bit of a miscount.
Clearly the 5 a.m. sleep time is getting to him.
Still has 700k on level 20, which is
remarkable
plenty.
Pace.
Yeah.
Rhubarb.
But, yeah, Rhubarb closing in on pretty much the same mark.
But still 4 lines behind, so a Tetris difference between the players still.
Yeah, so Wallbant's got a 1 Tetris lead, and for this much pace to only have a 1 Tetris lead, that's very unusual. Usually, if you're this far ahead, you're like 4 Tetris ahead or something. Down at the bottom, we have Sodium in the lead by about 100,000. It's not accounting for line count yet, but that's still a pretty substantial lead. About 3 Tetris.
Great adjustment from Wallbant.
Yeah, Wallbant with a little bit of a tough stack for a moment there, but look at how it's resolving. Very, very nice.
I'm now about 2 Tetrises ahead at the same line count. So, been playing very efficiently since that initial dig.
And Rhubarb is getting into a dig up here. We'll see how quickly he can resolve this. Again, this is going to be a very RNG dig where you just need the right piece at the right time. That's a good J, and that should let him get out of it.
Wallbant at the top two, really waiting for that long bar.
Yeah, it appears there is a drought on 23 somewhere. Wallbant cutting it close up here, but gets that Tetris.
Oof.
913,000
on pace for a 25 max here.
And again, we're playing to a max out. If Wallbant gets one more Tetris here, I think that clutches it.
It sure does. All he needs is this one. And he's
with
got
that, he's going to Tetris into 194 lines with a 25 max out. Wallbant will defeat Vicious Rhubarb. Incredible. And Rhubarb
Canada
with a 26
in the finals. That's not bad at all.
Yeah.
That's still...
extremely, extremely good game at the
no
top.
No burns
there.
From there, almost 1.3 in a kill screen.
Yeah.
So, not bad to get at all.
All right, down at the bottom, Sodium... Oh, it's hard to tell what this lead is, but it's. I think it's 100,000 still for Sodium.
Sure looks like it. Maybe so, closer to 60, 70,000?
Yeah, maybe.
But Fractal in this dig is going to open it back up.
Yeah. Yeah, Sodium ready to go into kill screen here. 2 more Tetrises. Probably maybe just 1 more.
Wow.
Nice S-spin there. That takes guts.
Doing the J-tuck instead would have been far worse. So
that
really
is
great
true.
Vision from Sodium.
And he's going to go into kill screen. He's now with an A38, early 29. Our line cap down at the bottom is going to be level 34. A little bit of some hangs there for Sodium. If he can get really good pieces here and really good rolls, he can survive this, but he's not going to be able to do it. He's going
to
top out at
A44 to win.
Yes, A44 is the score to win.
So about 100,000 to go. That's 3 Tetrises. And lining out to 34 will not be enough. So he needs at least a Tetris or 2 here, and
yeah.
Plenty of triples.
Ooh, some misdrops there from Fractal.
Definitely doable, but not comfortable, and it's definitely gonna make it harder for him to.
Ooh, overshot on that S piece. You don't often see an accidental like 8 left.
And Sodium takes it.
That's gonna give Sodium the advantage.
Game
2
point
to 1
now for Sodium.
Game point for Sodium. right. So their fourth line cap will be Faster Master is going to be starting on level 19, and there will be double kill screen at level 39. This is a bit more of what we're used to. We're just starting at 19 at transition. Yeah. All right. So we'll be counting it down in three, two, one. What? All right, a little bit of a misfire there. Sodium's not ready.
It's so always good when your players lie to you.
All right, looks like Sodium's good to go. Okay. All right, for real this time, let's try it again. Let's start in 3, 2, 1, Tetris. All right, so we are starting on 19 speed, and we'll be transitioning 10 lines in. So essentially, we've cut out the entire 18 segment of the game here. This is game point for Sodium.
Which,
so.
Thank God, because I don't know if I could stand another slog through 18 tonight.
Yeah, usually the 18 is the bit of the boring part. Ooh, unfortunate hang there for Fractal. I think that was more of a misflip than a hang. Yeah. The line cap will be at level 39 with
and
a
double
kill
screen.
So Sodium already in the lead because of that Fractal misdrop. Sodium setting up a, okay, it doesn't set up the center well actually. Sodium with the discipline.
Copewell?
Oh, wait, Copewell? Is that what we're calling it now?
I'm fine to call it a Copewell. That's a bit funny.
It was pretty low, so that was, like, relatively low stakes. But still, better not to. And now he's getting into a bit of a dig. 182 for Sodium, 161 for Fractal. On level 23.
Sodium's still ahead by one Tetris at the same line count.
You guys are at the same... Okay. All right.
My brain was really wanting a vits there from Sodium, but clearly he's more disciplined than I.
No JPs there for Sodium.
A very comfortable stack regardless.
It's not the most comfortable. I mean, he wasn't Tetris ready, but
it's not like
a bar didn't come
anyway.
So. Yeah, in retrospect, it did not matter. We're here on 26. We're already getting close to the kill screen. That's how fast this goes when you start at 19. Sodium with 320, still in the lead.
Wasn't able to use that bar, so Fractal getting himself back into contention.
Yeah, just one Tetris separating them. And really only 15 lines left before we hit regular kill screen. And then we have all of that before double kill screen at 39. Pretty average score here for, if not a bit on the low side. Usually people get 400, 500, sometimes 600 before 29. In the post-transition.
500 post is nothing to scoff at. Neither is a mid-400.
Yep. And Fractal is going to finish with a mid-400 into 29. And Sodium is going to get in with a 500 flat. So advantage for Sodium right now. So the pressure might be on Fractal right now to set up some Tetrises. And he's in a dig, so obviously he's not to be worried about that right now. Just about surviving. Some misdrops there. This is going to be a bit of a problem. Another misdraw. And he's back
and
holds
Sodium
together.
Takes it.
Sodium is going to upset Fractal, the number one seed. And we'll move on to the finals. So our finals will be Wallbant versus Sodium Overdose.